Hello friends, hope you all are well at your place. Today I am here again with another story, that is Shoot Wizard Hit Mummy by John Apatow. This story is from the book Vistas of class 12. Now before I start, let me ask you one thing. When you were small kids, you must have heard stories from your parents and also grandparents. So in a way, story was always linked with your life in one or the other way. And till this age also, I hope that you all are fond of hearing stories. In this chapter, if we see the title, Shoot Wizard Hit Mummy. Now this wizard is something who can perform magics, who can perform magic spell, and mummy is just an ordinary name, like we say to our own mothers. Some says mama, mummy, ma. So these are different names of a mother. Here in the story, there is a question in the title. So before I start with this chapter, it is very important to understand that why it was required by the writer John Updike to put a question mark. And this question mark is an open-ended question mark. And this is for the readers. This thing will be more clear to you when you will understand this chapter. In this chapter, there is one fascinating fact. And what is that? A story inside a story. That means, in the story, you will find that another story is being weaved by the narrator. So we have to focus on two stories. If we talk about the main story, that is story number one. Let us know about the characters. Jack's wife, Claire. Daughter, Joe, and son, Bob. So these are four main characters in the first story. Now this character Jack is going to narrate a short story to his daughter Joe. If we talk about the second story, the main character Roger's Skunk, Owl, Wizard, Mother. So, before I begin, I will tell you that this character of the first story, Jack, used to tell bedtime stories to his daughter, Jo. And with a slight variation, the story was almost the same basic tale which he used to tell every day, with few changes. The main character was always Roger, sometimes Roger Squirrel, sometimes Roger Fish. But the character name was same. And then the story was also same, that there was a small creature, Roger. He used to have some problem in the life. And then just to solve that problem, he used to go the wise owl. The owl suggested him to go to the wizard. The wizard solved the problem. Roger was happy and he used to play with other creatures. So this was the basic story. And with few changes, Jack used to narrate a different story with almost the same name. So his daughter Jo was also familiar of the story and she used to react according to that. Now, one day, it was Saturday evening. Jack started a new story. Now this time he asked Jo about the character. Then it was decided that today the main character of the story would be Roger Skunk. Now this name Skunk, it's a mammal in the West Hemisphere. You can see the pictures of a skunk while searching, you will find that it is like a squirrel and it is in black and white color form. So now this Roger Skunk, again here there is a slight variation. As I told you that every story used to have some problem of the main character, and in this story Roger Skunk had a terrible smell, and because of his terrible smell other creatures used to run away from him. Nobody was willing to be with him and play with that little skunk. Now, what happened? This Roger Skunk, he went to the wise owl. As Jack was narrating the story, Jo interrupted. Jo said, "Papa, now this Roger Skunk would visit the wise owl?" His father said yes, because he was suffering because of the bad odor that used to come from him. So this Roger Skunk went to the wise owl. The wise owl suggested that for your solution you must go to the wizard. He went to the wizard and he informed that the wise owl told him that the wizard would help you. The wizard agreed that little skunk was having a terrible smell. This wizard asked that little boy, "What kind of smell you want?" Skunk thought for a moment and then he said, "Roses." With his magic wand, the wizard converted that awful smell into the smell of roses. Now this little skunk was very happy because now the smell that was coming from him was that of roses. Other creatures played with him, and when it was dark, he went back to home and his mother. Here comes the character of Mummy. Skunk's mummy was shocked because now the smell was of roses. She was not happy with it and she asked, "Who had done all this?" Little boy, although he is not a boy, but just to compare this thing with our lives too. This little skunk, he told that other creatures were not happy with me. So this wizard turned that smell into the smell of roses. His mother was not satisfied. They went back to the wizard and now Mummy hit the wizard and she forced the wizard to change the smell as it was earlier. Now his skunk got the smell that was very awful. Again the same bad smell. But here is the twist. This skunk was happy with the smell of roses. But his mother told him that he should smell the way a little skunk should smell. And now again he got the same foul smell. And here The story ends by this little girl Jo. She interrupted her father. She wanted that. No, the wizard should hit mommy. Why? Because Joe's perspective, Joe's view about the world was totally different from her father's view. After the story was done, it was over. Now Jack came downstairs where his wife was busy. She was working, she was painting a chair. And then she asked that today the story was too long. Jack just said 3 words, the poor kid. And here the story ends, and today he is not even willing to help his wife because he was so much tired after the story narration. Here the story comes to an end. Two stories simultaneously. Joe narrated the story to his daughter Jo. Now this Jack, when he was narrating the story to Jo, although it's a simple tale, but if we come to the main point of this chapter, a question mark which I told you in the beginning, should wizard hit mommy? According to Jo, she wanted that the wizard should hit mommy because what she did was not appropriate. According to Jo, she is a child. Because of her innocence, she is saying like this, because of that foul smell, nobody was playing with skull. But on the other hand, if we talk about the decision that was taken by mommy of that Roger skull, the reason behind was that because of that foul smell, he was saved from the predators. Nobody was capable enough to harm him because of that foul smell. It was a kind of God-given protection to that little skunk, and his mother was aware of this fact. So here comes the theme of this story. Different perspectives of parents and children. Here comes a question that children should be allowed to do whatever they want, or the parents are the ones who can take the decision for their children. And here is the difference. That is why the writer put a question mark and he left a question for the readers to decide they can accept the statement or they can reject the statement that should wizard hit mommy. This is the perspective of that small girl Jo, and on the other hand, what actually happened in the story was mommy hit the wizard because that was required. Parents, they know that what is right and wrong, what is good or bad for their children. So it is all about perspective of the adult one, and on the other hand, perspective of an innocent child, because they are not aware of the realities, they are involved in their own magical world. But parents who have experienced the reality of this world, they are well aware of the things that are required or that are useful in one's life. So this is all about this chapter. Thank you so much. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell icon. Thank you so much.